some of the Christian culture lighten up with what gender has to mean or doesn't right. have to mean.
Well, and I think that's something, you know, people have said that, you know, Driscoll's new book is, you know, I think it's going to be to the discussion about equality, like gender equality, that Bell's book was to the discussion about, you know, hell and stuff mm-hmm. like that. I don't know that it's necessarily that everybody's going to agree, but I think it's going to bring that discussion to the forefront a lot more. Yeah.
And a lot of response, books in response.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I think it will. And I think that in that regard, while I'm not interested in reading Driscoll's book, I think it'll be, yeah, I think it'll be good for that, because I've seen a few people on Twitter say, where are the marriage books about egalitarian marriages? And I would say, yeah, I would be hard pressed to find one. They're almost all complementarian. And so I think that will be, I think his book, the release of it being really heavily in one direction, will probably, you know, encourage people who maybe feel differently to speak up and everything.
Eventually not be the intended result he was actually looking
yeah,
for.
Exactly.
if 10 books come out,
have been looking for a different outcome.
Yeah. 10 books come out saying, well, that's a bunch of crap. You
know, yep.
Like, what are you going to do? But, oh, man.
That, and I think when we overcome fear, it awakens this significance in us, I guess. And, we're able to see our own self-worth, and that's kind of what I'm looking for in the new book, is just stories about what have you overcome, what scary thing or circumstance or whatever have you gone through that when you came out the other side allowed you to say, yes, I have this value. Yes, I have this worth. And I think that's, you know, it's something that I experienced. And
yeah.
I think it's a, you know, an interesting thing. And we're still accepting submissions for that. So.
Oh, good. And how long will you be accepting submissions?
Right now we're accepting through the end of January. However, we're coming up a little short, so we'll probably extend that another month or so. But yeah. Any stories, anything 1,000 to 2,000 words you want to send on over.
Okay, good. That's good to put out there. And it really, in a sense, as I think about it, it's really stories about courage, because it's kind of like, you know, having courage doesn't mean you're not afraid.
Exactly.
It means you push through that fear. And
exactly, exactly.
Yeah.
That's what it is. So. I'm going to be going back a couple months ago. I wrote about my friendship with a man, my best friend, Rich, and I'm going to be speaking soon with Dan Brennan, who wrote a book, Sacred Union, Sacred Passions, and it's about cross-gender friendships, and I'm hoping to explore that a little bit more on the blog in the coming months. Probably in February I'll be looking into that.
Oh, yeah, and
it's not something that I think people have to have as a friendship with, you know, a cross-gender friendship or anything like that. But I think we've got to a point where we're so afraid of it, you know, of the potential downfalls of it, that we've ignored people who we could have a close relationship with just because, you know, they have different stuff than we have.
Right.
And I think that's unfortunate. I think that's unfortunate that, you know, that we've allowed fear, you know, to dictate who we can be friends with. And
yeah.
I think that's, you know, my greater side to it is not that we should or shouldn't have cross-gender friendships, but that we shouldn't be afraid of, you know,
that's
always what it boils down to for me, is how can I enrich this, you know, how can I bring together this relationship with me and this person, or with this group and this group? I think that for me feels like, if I'm going to say calling, is what I feel called to do, is to like see how can we build bridges between, you know, this person and this person. And I've seen it just in my own life with just relationships that are very unexpected to me, with my, you know, best friend from high school who comes out to me and says, you know, I'm a lesbian, and a best friend as an adult who's a male, and a husband who we shared faith with who I don't anymore. And these are all really important relationships to me, and you know, but aren't typical, I guess, or aren't expected. And I think just in a way of how can, you know, how does that work for me, and how can I, you know, express that in a way to other people? 'Cause
That's your next book.
Yeah, pretty
More or
much.
less, right?
That's it.